Is karate effective? Yes. Is that biased because I do karate? No. Maybe, but I will explain my opinion and hopefully can convince you as well. Also, look at this pig right here. Aren't you really tempted to pop that? Yeah, me too. That is why you should download Angry Birds 2. But instead of kicking the pigs, you have to launch them across the map from a slingshot and try and aim for those headshots. Now, this bird right here is called Red. He is the face of Angry Birds. All the birds have a special ability that makes them unique. Red's is a cool shockwave type ability that happens when you tap the screen, like this. I think my ability would be a flying sidekick. But maybe done a little bit better than that. Now, this bird is called Chuck. He is my favorite. Let me show you why. So you pull back the slingshot, fire him, and then when you tap the screen, he goes super speed and just pierces through anything in his way, which is how I like to think of my back kick. I hope. Now, I try and aim these birds precisely and only use the ability right at the last second, and it seems to work out for me. Now, when you pass these levels, you can get 1, 2, or 3 stars. I have got 3 stars on most of these levels, as you can see here. I'm a bit of a perfectionist, especially when it comes to a game as addictive as this. Now, you can also play the Tower of Fortune, which is a risky game within Angry Birds 2. You have to choose a card, and you can either get a reward behind it, or you can get a pig behind it, which means you lose. As you can see here, I leave and collect my rewards because I did not want to be seeing any pigs behind those cards. Angry Birds 2 is available on Android via the Google Play Store, or on iOS via the App Store. Hit the first link in my description and go and download this iconic game. Go do it. A lot of people say, and especially in my comments section, I see this a lot, that karate doesn't work, it's ineffective, it's watered down, it's rubbish, it's just should just quit, and no one should do it. And a lot worse, to be honest, that I'm not willing to say on YouTube. Obviously, I disagree with these comments, but I do know where they've come from. There's a couple of reasons people say this. Number one, McDojos. These are basically clubs that are run for the sole purpose of making money, and actual skill level is not a priority of these clubs at all. So basically, they will hand out a black belt to a six-year-old and then go to the parents and say, for an additional sum of money, I'll throw in a world title as well. That is pretty much a McDojo. Not all dojos are like this though, you have to understand this. Unfortunately, maybe quite a big percentage of them are, but real karate is still practiced. Karate was initially developed as a way of self-defense, and it was not intended to go down the route of money grabbing. You know, like, karate practitioners were hard. They were hard guys. Type of guys that spend 20 hours a day punching their fists into pots of glass to condition them. Those type of guys. But that kind of karate is still around. I mean, I don't know about the pots of glass. I don't do that, and I don't know anyone that does that. But real karate still exists, basically. And another reason why I think that people say that karate doesn't work is because of sport karate. Personally, I do not have anything against sport karate. I actually compete in sport karate, so it's a lot of fun. It's fun. That's all it is. It's just meant to be a game. It's not meant to work in the street. No one goes into a sport competition and says, this is gonna make me invincible on the street. No one says that. It's actually the people that don't do karate that then assume that the sport karate practitioners think that this is gonna work outside, but we don't. And although I do practice sport karate, I also practice traditional karate. I also spar full contact with my coach. You can practice both, you can have a balance, and that's what people don't understand. They think that sport karate is all of karate. That's just a small part of it. You don't go to a basketball game and say, hang on a minute, that wouldn't work in a fight. Well, no, it wouldn't, because they don't claim it would work in a fight. And it's also basketball. It's the same thing. Sport karate is a game. It's not meant to work in a fight. Anyway, I'm not going to go into that rabbit hole because that could last a while. There are practitioners of karate that have been successful in MMA, which is what people say is the ultimate test of whether a martial art works. For example, Wonderboy Stephen Thompson, brilliant. Lyoto Machida, legend. GSP, nothing more needs to be said. Oliver Enkamp, also. I met him actually, he's a really nice guy as well. Those guys, just to name a few, have made karate work in MMA. All it simply comes down to is if you can take the techniques of karate and apply them in a more real way, which is easily done because real karate is taught in a real way. Me personally, when I train kicks, for example, sometimes I will practice snapping the kick off at the target to practice my control, and also just as a training exercise. But then also when we get the bigger bags out, I also train slicing the bag in half. You know, you can train both. And it's about taking the aspects of that would work in MMA, the harder kicks, the kicks where you connect with the shin rather than the top of the foot. You take those aspects and put them into MMA rather than the top of the foot toe taps. Like, they're good for training your leg control, but maybe not very effective in MMA. That is literally all it is. It's not a matter of karate as a whole doesn't work. It's just you take the parts of karate that would work and put them into MMA, and it works, as proven by the guys that I said earlier. I also hear a lot of people saying, oh, karate is not as good as boxing or Muay Thai. It's not as effective. It doesn't work in the street. It doesn't work in MMA. I would argue that that's because in boxing, you don't get as much or any mukdojos of boxing, really, because I feel like something like boxing is very straightforward. It is just like, you know, punches, hands. There's only so many ways you can practice boxing, whereas with karate, I feel like it was more susceptible to being modernized. For example, with the belt system and stuff, people saw the way you can charge people to move up in the ranks, and you know, they took advantage of that and started making loads of money out of it. Whereas with boxing, you know, it's just straightforward. You don't earn belts, you train and you fight, which is one of the differences between the two that I think had an effect on why karate went down more of a money grabbing route. And also, a lot of people will say, oh, karate techniques are not as powerful as Muay Thai techniques. That is just rubbish. Karate has pretty much the same techniques as Muay Thai. It's just, it's all down to how the practitioner throws them. Again, I'm going to use Wonderboy as an example. He's been very successful in the UFC. He throws his kicks like a karate practitioner, but he throws the kicks well. It's not about, oh, that kick is good because it's a Muay Thai kick. It's that kick is good because he threw it well. That's what some people need to understand. For example, let me demonstrate. Everyone says how Muay Thai throws elbows, karate doesn't. That's not true. Now, we train to throw elbows as well. It's not a solely Muay Thai thing. And with kicks and stuff, people say, oh, Muay Thai technique is better. We'll pretend that looked like a Muay Thai kick. How can it be better? Because in karate, we train to throw it like that. So they didn't really look like much difference. There is only so many ways you can throw a roundhouse kick. I think what people do is they see other people commenting and they jump on the bandwagon. That's definitely what's happened with this whole like Muay Thai thing. I don't hate Muay Thai. I think I respect it and I think it's very good. I don't like the keyboard warriors that have jumped on this hype saying that Muay Thai destroys everything else. Yes, it's a very effective art and yes, it's good for combat, but you don't really see anyone in MMA go in with that Muay Thai stance because it's too narrow, which is the same thing with karate. Muay Thai as an art on its own would not do well in MMA because this style of stance would be too susceptible to being taken down, for example. Same with karate, the sport style of karate stance, which is really wide, would also not be very good in MMA, which is why people adapt it, make it slightly shorter and, you know, better for the full contact style. But yeah, I didn't really plan this video. I just thought I'd come out and talk about it. So I hope you did enjoy and I hope you can take something from it if you can. If not, then I hope you just enjoyed watching me hopelessly defend karate. But yeah, moral of the video, I suppose, is don't talk smack about a martial art if you don't know the full thing. Always respect other arts because you never know. Next time you're at training, someone from Aikido could come through the door and absolutely wipe the floor with you. But yes, also subscribe if you haven't already. If you're watching these videos and you haven't subscribed, change that, subscribe. We're trying to get to 1 million. I'm trying to do it by early next year, maybe. I don't think we're gonna do it by the end of this year because it's getting pretty close now. But please subscribe, let's get to 1 million and like this video. Comment what kind of long videos you would like to see me do next. And I will see you in the next video.